When you're young and you're thinking about what you want to do with your life, you're not instructed to dream that big and see that much of a vision. And it was always a fantasy to get to sing at all, to have talent, to be able to produce music and write music. And then when you get into the fact that there are other people who enjoy your music as much as you do, well, I mean, that just throws you a complete curveball.
He is a teenage, mixed race, you know, half white, half African American guy who, from Colorado, who loves traditional country music. I mean, right there, that's enough to make you go, huh, you know.
When I was born, Mom wrapped me up in a Wu-Tang Clan t-shirt. So country music wasn't quite what I was bred on, you may say, but it's definitely something that I've developed a love for. And I just love all good music. I don't try to draw any boundaries. Every job you have, you get faced with obstacles where, you know, how do you maneuver through this or that? And I think that my biggest thing in adjusting is learning how to evolve yet not change. I am really wanting to do something that breaks the genre of country music, because what I'm finding right now is every other song I hear on country radio is about beers and trucks and making out with your girlfriend on the tailgate of your truck, which is cool, but I can't relate to that. I'm not going to sing about something that I can't relate to. You know, I get down when I get into country music, I do some of the more traditional music, the Ray Price, the Jeannie Seelys, the Roddy Millsaps, Hank Williams, you know, all that, the hearty stuff. But then I can go in and throw a James Taylor song or a Lionel Richie song, or be able to mix that in. And I know that that's where I'd like for my music to evolve, because there's also that African-American heritage that I have, where there's going to be a little more soul in the music that I do. I can play on the back of my head.
That's crazy. Right behind
me. What facial expressions? I think about it like this. Barack Obama is the only African-American U.S. president we've ever had. And we've had 45 presidents, so that's one out of 45. Well, in the ratio of black country music singers, it's like one black guy versus 2,000.
Wheels to rolling as I pull it on to the interstate. I've got 13 hours to make my destination, and I don't want to stop to check my weight. There won't be no sleep for me tonight, no. I've gotta be heading Tulsa by first morning light, I'm afraid.
Oh my goodness, the most rewarding thing. I think it is that I wake up every single day and I have no idea how my day's going to turn out. Every time I have a horrible day and things just aren't going right, I'll walk to the Walmart by my house and somebody will recognize me and take a picture with me, or have me sign an autograph for them. And it's like, okay, well, my problems aren't too bad then in the gist of things. So the fun thing, I guess, about being me is I get to wake up and do what I love and support myself doing it. and also to help others. We've done several charity events just in the past year that did very well. We're so excited about that. I remember a particular show, The Taste of Colorado. I played that festival on, I think it was actually Memorial Day when I played that. And we came, and days before, there was the big Houston hurricane. And I said, you know what? All the merch that we sell, we ought to donate a large portion of the proceeds to Houston, to the Red Cross there. Because I get to sing up and get up on stage and sing, but what about the people who are dying down there? So, and then before that, we've done some scholarship shows and really getting people and communities involved, and it's just wonderful. And I know that on this next tour, I'm always constantly looking for a great organization to represent and really champion, because there's just so many great causes out there.
To another line of work, but my heart.